Rich Text Editor is a built-in property editor in Umbraco that allows users to create and edit personalized and complex content. Small websites can be created with just this editor. My name is Elena, and in this video I'll walk you through the process of working, configuring, and making the Rich Text Editor customizable using plugins, blocks, and styles. Before starting, you will need to have an Umbraco project installed on your local machine, preferably on the latest version. So here I have a project on the latest version, version 13. So first things first, let's set up a homepage with a rich text editor. So we go to the settings, document types, then we create a document type with template. Let's call this home. We add a group called content, and then we add a property. We can call this property body. Then let's select an editor, and here we are looking for rich text editor. Here we have two options. We can either choose the default configuration, or if you would like to add more configurations of the rich text editor, it's recommended to create a new rich text editor. I will create a new configuration of the rich text editor, which we can see it will take the name of my document type, then the property alias, and then the editor. Here are all the default configurations that Rich Text Editor comes with. In total, there are 35 settings that we can enable or disable. But we will take a look at this later on, so let's just go ahead and submit and save. Now let's make sure that we are able to create our homepage at the root of our content. So let's go ahead and create a new content. We can call this home. And here we have our rich text editor. Let's write some content. Hello from the rich text editor. Let's see what are the current options that we have right now. So if you click on the code tags, we can view the source code of our content. As we can see by default, the rich text editor in Umbraco, it has paragraph tags. So whenever we write a new, let's say, test, then we go to the source code, we can see it has a paragraph. Then we are able to choose some format stylings. So for example, if we select the text, we can make it as a header, section header, paragraph. Also blocks, we can make it as a quote, code. We can make it bold, italic, align to the left, align to center, align to right. We can choose some listings. We can decrease the indent or increase it. We can also add a link. We can add some medias or macro. If, for example, we have forms that we can add into our content. And we also have the embed. Great. So now if we save and publish, and if you would like to see it on our front end, of course, we are not able to see it because we have not rendered it in our template. So the way to render the rich text editor is to go to the template, and then we can add model.body. And there it is. Now we have the content from our rich text editor shown on the front end. Great, now let's add more options into our rich text editor. So we go back to our settings, home, then we click on the cogwheel, we click on edit, and now we can choose, let's say, remove the format, strike through. As I'm not using this much that often, I can disable them. Then I can also add a horizontal rule or table. Here we can add some style sheets, which we are gonna work with them a little bit later on. Then we can choose the dimensions of the editor. Let's say 500 with 500 pixels. This is the maximum size for the images that we can add into our rich text editor. Then we can choose the mode if it's classic or inline, in the meaning that if we choose inline, then we will see all these options above on each line that we select. Or if we choose classic, then they will stick to the top. I will leave it to the inline so we can see the example. We will work with the blocks later on as well. As for the overlay size, you can select the width of the link picker overlay. We can also hide the label, and this means that the label and description for the rich text editor property will be hidden. I'll just leave it as it is. We can choose an image upload folder. I will click on plus and name this one rich text editor. From now on, whenever I add an image from the rich text editor, then they will be saved in the RTE folder in the media folder. Then there's also the option to ignore user start nodes, which means that some users might be restricted to a specific part of the content tree. When this is enabled, the users can pick any piece of content from the content tree when adding internal links through the rich text editor. Let's go ahead and submit and save. So now if we go back, we can see that the height and width of the editor has been changed to 500 with 500 pixels. This is the inline, so that for each text that we select, we can see the options individually. So let's add an image, which I have one right here. So we can change the size if we would like to. So let's go ahead to the body. Let's go ahead to change the configuration of the rich text editor. And here we can select, let's say, 200 pixels. So if we go back to the content and then we try to add our image, we can see that it shows much smaller, and on the front end as well. I will also go ahead back and change the rich text editor to show as classic, as I prefer it that way. In this video, we have learned how to implement rich text editor in our content, how to render it on our front end so it can show on our website, and how we can enable or disable the default options according to our needs. In the next video, I will cover how we can extend the rich text editor by adding a plugin. Stay tuned for the next video.